In this video, we're going to look at enabling the setgid flag and the sticky bit. The setgid flag is for setgroupID. And to see how this works, we're going to use the chemistry group directory that we created in an earlier video in this tutorial series. To see what users we have in the chemistry group, I'm going to type get ent group chemistry. And we see the users Lisa and Ryan. We updated Ryan's GID to be chemistry, and we can see that when we type ID Ryan. I will type ID Lisa to show that Lisa still has her original group of Lisa. I'm going to open a new terminal tab with the light colored theme that we created back at the beginning of this tutorial series. I'm going to switch to the user Lisa with sudo su-lisa. Lisa is a member of the chemistry group, so she can cd into the /srv/chemistry directory, and she can create a file with touch testfile4.txt. Typing ls-lh, we see that Lisa has the same problem that Ryan had. When Lisa creates a file, it sets her group ID as the new file's group ID. To get around this problem, Ryan changed his group ID to be chemistry, and Brenda used the new grp command to temporarily change her group ID to be chemistry. We don't want to make all the chemistry group members update their GID or make them new GRP before making any files in the chemistry directory. That is where the setGID bit comes in. Because we need to be a privileged user to set the GID flag, I'm going back over to the terminal tab where I'm logged in as Michael. I'm going to type ls-lh/srv to show the chemistry directory user owner and group have read, write, and execute permissions, while other has no permissions at all. To enable the setGID flag for the chemistry group, I'm going to type sudo chmod g+s/srv/chemistry. And to show the permissions were updated, I will type ls-lh/srv. And we see we have enabled the setgid bit because we see the lowercase s in place of the group execute bit. Now let's switch over to the terminal tab where Lisa is signed in. And I will create a file with touch testfile5.txt ls-lh. And we see when Lisa creates a file now in the chemistry directory, the group ID is set to chemistry. So here we see that enabling the setgid flag for a directory will give new files created in that directory the group of that directory. To disable the setgid, I will need to switch back to the Michael user. And we can disable that setgid flag with sudo chmod g-s/srv/chemistry. And then typing ls-lh/srv shows the setgid flag has been disabled. Going over to the other tab and typing touch testfile6.txt and then ls-lh. We see the new file was created with the group of Lisa. Going back over to the terminal where I'm logged in as Michael, I'm going to enable the setgid flag again, but this time I'm going to use the octal permissions. This is similar to what we saw in the last video, where we added the number 4 before the 770 for set UID. For the set GID, we're going to add the number 2. So I will type sudo chmod 2770/srv/chemistry. Switching over to the other tab, the Lisa user will create another file with touch testfile7.txt and ls-lh shows us the new file has the group of chemistry. Going back to the terminal tab where I'm logged in as Michael, I'm going to clear the screen. Now we're going to look at how the sticky bit works. When people talk about the sticky bit, the explanation usually starts with the /tmp directory. The /tmp directory is a place where temporary files are stored. These files will be deleted after 10 days or on the next system reboot, whichever comes first. I'm going to type ls-lh/ so we can see the /tmp file permissions. The thing to notice here is the file execute permissions for other. We see a lowercase t instead of the lowercase x that lets us know the sticky bit is enabled. We are going to use the chemistry directory, which we already have set up, to show how this sticky bit works. I'm going over to the other tab where I'm logged in as Lisa, and I'm going to log out of Lisa with exit. And now I'm going to log in as Ryan with sudo su-ryan. I'm going to clear the screen and cd into the SRV chemistry directory. Typing ls-lh, we see the four files that were just created by Lisa, two files with the group of Lisa, and two with the group of chemistry. I'm going to type nano testfile7.txt, and Ryan can edit this file. I'm holding down Control X, Y, Enter. And now Ryan will attempt to edit test file 6 with nano testfile6.txt. And we see the message file testfile6.txt is unwritable. Holding down Control and pressing X to exit out. Now Ryan is going to try and delete testfile 7 with rm testfile7.txt, and that gets removed without a problem. He's now going to try and remove testfile6.txt. He gets a message here asking him to confirm that he wants to remove testfile6.txt, a file that he does not have access to edit. Ryan will type yes, press enter, and typing ls-lh shows that both testfile 7 and testfile 6, which he has no access to edit, were both deleted. I'm going back over to the other terminal tab where I'm logged in as Michael. I'm going to clear the screen and check the permissions of the chemistry group with ls-lh/srv. And now we want to set the sticky bit for the chemistry directory. To do that, I will type sudo chmod o plus t. The o is for other, the t is for sticky bit, and we want to do that for the SRV chemistry directory. And because there's only one t, we don't need that o. I can say chmod plus t to add the sticky bit to the /SRV chemistry directory. Pressing enter, we have set the sticky bit. I'm going over to the other terminal tab. And now Ryan will try and remove the testfile4.txt file that has a group of Lisa, asking to confirm that he wants to remove that file. He types Y, and now he gets a permissions denied. Ryan will try and remove testfile5. That file has a group of chemistry. Pressing enter, he does not have permissions to remove that file either. Now Ryan's going to try and remove testfile3.txt. Ryan is the user owner of that file. Pressing enter, typing ls-lh shows Ryan was able to remove a file that he was the user owner of. And that goes for every user in this directory. So the sticky bit works with the remove command, and when that is set, the user owner can only remove their own files. One last thing we need to do is go back over to the other terminal tab and type ls-lh/srv. And we see an uppercase T for the sticky bit. Because other does not have execute access for this file, it is an uppercase T, which is what we want. To remove this sticky bit, I will type sudo chmod minus t, and it could be O minus t, slash SRV chemistry. And the sticky bit is removed. I do want to enable a sticky bit again, and this time using the octal method. And with that, the sticky bit is going to be a value of 1. Remember in the last video, we enabled the setUID with a value of 4. Then earlier in this video, we enabled the setGID with a value of 2. And when we have no special permissions, we have the value of 0. So now we have the sticky bit. That will have a value of 1. But we also want to enable the setGID flag. So we will want to add the 1 and the 2 together. Sudo chmod 3770 slash SRV slash chemistry. 1 is for the sticky bit, 2 is for the GID bit, and when we add them together, we get the 3. Now, typing ls-lh slash SRV shows us the sticky bit is enabled once again. In the next video, we will continue to look at more Linux advanced file permissions.